Hello everyone, I am K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Welcome to a video lecture on even and odd signals. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to identify even and odd signals, find even and odd component of the signal. These are the some of the contents: even signal, odd signal, properties of even and odd signals, even and odd component, references. Even signal. A signal x of t or x of n is referred to as an even signal if it is identical to its time reversed counterpart, that is, with its reflection about the origin. In continuous time, a signal is even if it satisfies the condition x of minus t is equal to x of t for all t. Similarly, for a discrete time signal, is even if it satisfies the condition x of minus n is equal to x of n. Even signals are symmetric about the vertical axis or time origin. X of t is an even signal. If you take x of minus t, time reversal of this signal or mirror image of this signal, both must be same. Let us see here. So this is my x of minus t. These two signals are same, then it is an given signal, is an even signal. So this is an example for discrete time even signal. Then odd signal. A signal is referred to as odd if it satisfies the condition x of t is equal to minus of x of minus t for all t. For continuous time signal, x of n is equal to minus of x of minus n for discrete time signal. An odd signal must necessarily be 0 at t equal to 0 or n equal to 0. Odd signals are anti-symmetric about the time origin. The given x of t is an odd signal. Now we find the x of minus t, that is time reversal of this signal or mirror image of this signal. Next to find the minus of x of minus t, which is the amplitude scaling by minus 1. That means the signal which is present above this x axis will shift towards below this x axis. The signal which is present below this x axis will shift the above x axis. The first x of t and x of minus t are same, therefore it is an odd signal. Discrete time example for odd signal. Let us see here x of n. This is minus of x of minus n. These two must be same. Now see step by step. My x of minus n will be whatever the signal which are present at n equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 should shift at n equal to 1, 2, 3 respectively. Similarly, the signals which are present at n equal to 1, 2, 3 should shift at n equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 respectively. This is a x of minus n or mirror image of this signal x of n. Next, amplitude scaled by minus 1. The signal which are present at the below this x axis will shift to above this x axis, and signal which are present at above the x axis will shift to below the x axis. This is x of n, this is x of minus of x of minus n. These two are same, therefore it is an odd signal. Then properties of even and odd signal. First one is product of an even signal and an odd signal results into odd signal. Second one, the product of two even signals results into even signal, and two odd signal results into even signal. Third one, the summation of an odd signal x of n for all n is always 0. Their proofs we shall see now. Product of an even and odd signal. Consider x1 of n be an odd signal and x2 of n be an even signal. So therefore x1 of minus n is equal to minus x1 of n. This is equation number 1. Similarly, x2 of minus n is equal to x2 of n. This is equation number 2. Because this is an even signal, this is an odd signal. Let y of n is equal to x1 of n multiplied by x2 of n. Equation number 3. Replace n by minus 1 in the above expression. Therefore, y of minus n is equal to x1 of minus n into x2 of minus n. Equation number 4. Substituting equation 1 and 2 in 4. Therefore, y of minus n is equal to x1 of minus n is odd signal at minus of x1 of n. Similarly, this if I considered even, x2 of minus n becomes x2 of n. This is equal to minus of x1 of n multiplied by x2 of n. This is equal to minus of y of n. Therefore, y of minus n is equal to minus y of n. Therefore, it is product of even and odd signal results into odd signal. Proof number 2, product of two even and two odd signals. Let y of n is equal to x1 of n multiplied by x2 of n. Replace n by minus n. Y of minus n is equal to x1 of minus n multiplied by x2 of minus n. Let x1 of n and x2 of n be even signals. So, y of minus n is equal to, if I substitute that is even signals, it becomes x1 of n into x2 of n. Therefore, y of minus n is equal to y of n, product of two even signals results into even signal. Similarly, if x1 of n and x2 of odd signals, then y of minus n is equal to, so x1 of minus n becomes minus x1 of n, x2 of minus n becomes minus x2 of n because it is an odd signal. So if you product of these two becomes equal to y1 of n multiplied by x1 of n multiplied by x2 of n, which is equal to y of n. Their product is x1 of n multiplied by x2 of n, which is equal to y of n. The product of two odd signal results into an even signal. Summation of an odd signal. Consider x of n is an odd signal, y of n is equal to summation equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n. If I divide the limits from minus infinity to infinity, so if I change the sign here, n equal to minus 1 to plus minus infinity now becomes equal to 1 to infinity. If I change the summation sign here, the n sign also changes here. Summation equal to 1 to infinity x of minus n plus x of 0 plus summation equal to 1 to infinity x of n. We know if it is an odd signal, x of minus n equal to minus x of n. This becomes minus of summation n equal to 1 to infinity x of n plus x of 0 plus summation equal to 1 to infinity x of n. So there is a minus sign, there is a plus sign, these two get cancels, only x of 0 remains, which is equal to 0, as x of n is 0 at n equal to 0 for any odd signal. Even and odd components. The x of t can be expressed as even and odd components. X of t is equal to xe of t plus xo of t. This is equation number 1. Replace t by minus t in the above expression. X of minus t is equal to xe of minus t plus xo of minus t. X of minus t is equal to, if it is an even signal, x of minus t is equal to x of t. Therefore, xe of minus t becomes xe of t and x of o of minus t becomes minus x of t. This is equation number 2. Adding equation 1 and 2. So, x of t plus x of minus t is equal to 2xe of t. The even component is given by xe of t is equal to 1 by 2 into x of t plus x of minus t. Subtracting equation 2 from 1, x of t minus x of minus t is equal to 2xo of t. Therefore, the odd component is given by xo of t is equal to 1 by 2 into x of t minus x of minus t. Similarly, for discrete times signal, the even and odd components are xe of n is equal to 1 by 2 into x of n plus x of minus n. xo of n is equal to 1 by 2 into x of n minus x of minus n. Draw the waveform and identify the even and odd signals for the following signal. First one is y is equal to cos x, second y equal to sin x. Pause the video for a moment and think and write your answer. This is a cosine wave or cos of x. It is an even signal. Similarly, this is a sine wave. We can see here. This is an odd signal. Find the even and odd components of x of t for the given signal x of t. We know that the even and odd components is given by xe of t is equal to 1 by 2 into x of t plus x of minus t. xo of t is equal to 1 by 2 into x of t minus x of minus t. If I want to find even component, we need to have x of minus t also. convert that is x from x of t to x of minus t. That is x of minus t is the mirror image of this signal. Take x of t and x of minus t, find x of t plus x of minus t. So, from minus 2 to minus 1, this is 0 and this is minus 1. You are going to get minus 1. From minus 1 to plus 1, this is 1, this is also 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 2. From plus 1 to 2, this is minus 1, this is 0, you are going to get minus 1. Next is x e of t is equal to 1 by 2, this much. You divide it by this signal by 2, you are going to get this signal. Similarly, x of t minus x of minus t, subtract x of minus t from x of t. From minus 2 to minus 1, this is 0 and this is minus 1. 0 minus of minus 1 equal to plus 1. From minus 1 to plus 1, this is 1, this is also 1, it becomes 0. From 1 to 2, x of t is minus 1, x of minus t is 0, that is minus 1 minus 0 equal to minus 1. If you divide it by this signal by 2, you are going to get x of t. These are the references I have referred to prepare the above PPT. Thank you.